To the streets in Ashwaubenon tonight in honor of those affected by Monday's bombing, including athletes who were in Boston when the explosions happened. NBC26's Jonathan Gregg is live at 10 with more.
Stacy, it's called Run for Boston, coinciding with regular training for the Bell and Run, but for runners having greater meaning, a symbol to describe how the country is responding to a terrorist act.
Every runner knows.
Perfect running conditions.
There's a point in the race when you hit a wall and you feel like you can't go on.
I heard an explosion. I looked in the direction of the explosion, the noise.
For all of us, that wall was Monday.
Adrenaline at that point. I mean, I'm literally sprinting through the streets of Boston, you know, concerned about my family.
And it extended from Boylston Street, Boston, to Green Bay and beyond.
Today, Boston doesn't seem so far away. Why is that?
Again, we're a really tight community.
But then you dig deep.
Races like the Boston Marathon and the Bell and Run need to go on.
And take a race, or life in general, one step at a time.
Good crowd today.
That's exactly what these runners are doing.
It's simple, really. Something terrible happens, but they don't run away from it. They run straight at it. No fear.
I run a lot of races, and I plan on keep on running races.
Just run. Just run for those people, run for those victims.
And every day on, until we finish, until we are healed.
125 people showed up for the Run for Boston, many of them wearing blue and yellow, the official colors of the Boston Marathon. Jonathan Gregg, NBC 26.